The greatest magicians have something to learn from Mr. Mistopheles' conjuring turn. And we all say, oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever at magical Mr. Mistopheles. He is quiet, he is small, he is black, from the ears to the tip of his tail. He can creep through the tiniest crack, he can walk on the narrowest rail. He can pick any card from the pack, he is equally cunning with dice. He's always deceiving you into believing that he's only hunting for mice. He can play any trick with a cork or a spoon and a bit of fish paste. And if you look for a knife or a fork and you think it is merely misplaced, you have seen it one moment, then it is gone. You find it next week lying out on the lawn. And we all say,
oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as magic, no, Mr. Mistopheles. Oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as magic, no, Mr. Mistopheles.
My manner is vague and aloof, you would think there was nobody shyer, but my voice has been heard on the roof when I was curled up by the fire. And I've sometimes been heard by the fire when I was about on the roof. At least they all heard that somebody purred, which is incontestable proof of my singular magical powers. And I've known the family to call me in from the garden for hours when I was asleep in the hall. And not long ago, this phenomenal cat produced 7 kittens right out of a hat. And we all say,
oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as magical Mr. Mistopheles.
Do 7 kittens right out of a hat. And we all say,
oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as magical Mr. Mistopheles.
I give you the magical Mr. Mistopheles!